In today's video, we're gonna look at a snowblower that's pretty cool because it runs entirely on a battery. This is the Toro Power Clear E21. Now, I don't particularly like the name, but I do like the machine. I wanna be clear in stating the equipment was provided to me free of charge, but the review is my own and I had no requirements whatsoever as to what I had to say or show. When you take it out of the box, this is exactly what you're going to get, and it's great because there's no bags of screws or brackets. It's pretty much ready to go. They only give you two parts that are separate from the machine, and you can just put those aside, fold your handle into position, tighten these thumb screws, and now you can just pull the handle back. This is a huge win because for the most part, the machine is ready to go. But there is some confusion around how you attach this chute. I saw some reviews online, so I wanted to show you how you put it together. You have to angle one side of this to get a tab to slip through this slot. That part's easy, but then you have to go to the opposite side, and unfortunately, once you line up this hole in the plug, you're not quite done. You've got to go on the inside of the chute and you'll see this small tab. You can push it through with your fingers, but I wasn't able to do it easily. So I simply used a flathead screwdriver and got it to go in a position.
There's a hole right here you're gonna line up. And all you do is slide the handle in. There's a whole slot here. Don't even worry about where it goes. Just push it in. There's a guide in there that puts it into place for you.
The chute rotates easily. It's a good solid design. You can also change the angle of where the snow is gonna go. And at this point, you're done assembling the snowblower and you're ready to move on to the battery.
They have a really simple design. There's no tools required. Just open this door. And this is Toro's high amp battery. This is a 60 volt, 4 amp hour battery. It's a pretty cool thing. It's got a built-in power gauge and it just drops right into the machine. Push it in to lock it in, close the door, and that's it.
The Toro batteries I tested were all good. They're 60 volt lithium ion and they come in different sizes. So if you want to spend less, you can get a smaller version of the battery, but you won't get as long of runtime. If you get the bigger ones, you can run for much longer. But when you're buying a battery system, the real reason to buy into it is because you can run more than one piece of equipment using the same battery. And in this case, this is Toro's battery powered lawnmower. Take the battery out of your snowblower from the winter, and now you can use it all summer long. But obviously these batteries aren't compatible with other brands, so you want to make sure that you're getting one that you're really happy with.
The things that I found most different about the Toro are the build quality. The plastics definitely are better made. Everything, the doors, things like that, seem pretty solid to me. Now remember, Toro's been making these forever. They've had those two-stroke and four-stroke versions of this style machine for ages. These are real rubber tires, which is pretty unusual on a machine like this. Even this impeller is actually metal. These sides are also metal. One of the other biggest reasons to buy a machine like this is there's really like no maintenance on it. The only thing you'd ever have to do is there is this scraper bar in the bottom, and because it does clean so closely to the ground, at some point you're gonna have to replace it. But it's just a couple of screws. There's one here and on the opposite side. There is a belt inside this cover, but again, it's just a few screws and it can be changed pretty easily.
Another thing I loved about the Toro is it is so easy to use. You just simply squeeze the handle on the left, press that blue button in the middle, and the machine turns on. It couldn't be any easier, and that's a huge win for an electric machine. And on the opposite side here on the right, they've included this eco switch. All that does is slow down the motor to make the battery last longer. I don't think personally I would ever use that, but it could be helpful if you had really light snow and you wanted to maximize your battery. Now on to the snow test. Now this has been a very unusual year here. We've only gotten a little bit of snow. Here we've got a couple of inches. It's wet and icy, perfect for snowballs, but it's not a lot in terms of height. But as you know, with any kind of snowfall, the height of the snow isn't always what matters. It depends how dense it is and how wet it is. And in this case, it did a really good job cleaning the deck. In fact, you can see what a good job it did getting right down to the boards. But the more important part here was the fact I could even carry it up onto the deck. And that's a huge win when using any kind of battery system because they're going to be a lot lighter. I also found a number of reviews online from owners that were very happy with the performance of the machine. Now personally, I didn't get to try it in a foot of snow, but others did and they said it was pretty good. Now this next test looks a bit like a joke. It's only about an inch of snow on my front walk, but it's telling you more than you think. A normal snowblower cannot move this little snow because the tolerances are so loose. This machine is pretty tight and it had no problem at all scraping this tiny amount of snow out and moving it right out the chute. And when you're all done, this is how you can store it in the off season. You can keep it in its fully assembled position, but if you want it to take the least amount of space, you just have to unscrew those knobs, and then you can even pull out the chute adjuster handle, and it really takes very little space. You never have to take that chute off again, so that makes life a little bit easier. My overall impression of this machine was very good. Most cordless snowblowers are built like absolute junk. The Toro is not at all, but they've made these for many years in their gas form, so they have a lot of experience, and that obviously showed up in this one. But I think the biggest reason to get one of these is for somebody that doesn't want to deal with power equipment. You just put the battery in and use it. There's really nothing more to do. Now, in terms of negatives, the only things I really found were the price. It's not cheap, but you are paying for a pretty high quality unit. And the only other negatives were kind of small. It was around assembling the chute. I did see a lot of reviews about that, but hopefully my showing you that in the video will make that piece be a little bit easier to do. So hopefully you found this video interesting, maybe helpful if you are considering getting a battery powered snowblower. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming up.